Oh, this is the demo setup. Here's the DGT board, the induction chessboard, and DGT board is wired up to this computer on the top screen with Bluetooth. The induction board is running through an Arduino system and it's routed by this USB cable into the same computer, but it's on the bottom screen. Let's see. So this is the microcontroller. This is the voltage booster for the induction sensors that's underneath this board. These are just the shift registers to read the board's output, because there's so many squares, and we're using just a few of the digital inputs to the Arduino. And of course, this board uses the regular tournament pieces. The piece just needs to be weighted, because the weights have some metal in it, and it gets detected. The DGT board, of course, uses the standard DGT pieces. Okay, let's see. Oh, yeah, this computer is just let me go through the demo steps. So it's really not part of the demo, just something for me to see. Let's see. Actually, I'll put the tripod on this side so we can see the induction board better. The DGT board, I think everyone knows very well. So I think this is the best I can do. Maybe a little closer. Okay. And as for the screen, you don't have to see it very well because I have a screen recorder. So I'll record it and I'll do picture in picture. That'll be the first time I try. Okay. So let's see. Okay. First, we want to demonstrate D4, E4 using the D4 and E5 using sliding pickup change of mind while maintaining touch method. Okay, so let's try D4. We're gonna slide D4. There we go. And we'll do it to DGT too. Slide D4. And the DGT board is not working. That's because the DGT board is not connected. That's the thing with DGT. It's kind of funky. Sometimes it doesn't connect well if you change a few things. DGT software, I think, is the weak spot in the DGT stuff. You have to quit. Okay, let's see. How do I do this? Like this? This? No, that's not what I want. DGT. There's DGT. I had to install DGT on this computer. Computer is my son's computer. I didn't want to use my real computer for this demo because I'm installing this screen recorder software and I have no idea how dangerous that software is. It's a free software, so whenever you deal with free software, you always have to be very careful about you always have to be very careful about putting it on sensitive computers. Okay, so we start recording. I forgot to record, but you'll see. Yeah. The red frame is where we're at. Okay, now I'm recording. So that was E4, I mean D4, and the next move is D5. So boink. D5. Here we go. Oh, by the way, initially you don't see the D4 here in my board because in order to support sliding of movements, not just pick up and drop,
sliding of movements, we need to be pretty tricky with the software in that we want to go backwards in the software, undo certain things and redo certain things. But you will see the D4 and D5 eventually after all that redo. Okay, so next one is, let's see, D5 and E4. So we want to go D5. Oh, wait, I made a mistake. We want E5, not this one. Okay, let's go back. Everybody back home. There we go, everybody's home. Okay, I'll reset everything. Okay, and the DGT board is nice in that, the DGT board is nice and not nice. Whenever it gets confused, it generates a new PGN file. So in this case, we're lucky that it generated a new PGN file. My board has, it's designed for young scholastic player tournament play. So sometimes people make illegal moves, and after a couple moves, they realize it, or even after one move, they realize it's illegal. So they'll move backwards, and I have intelligence in it to handle that. So in order for it to generate a new PGN, I just tell it to reset the program. It has a non-volatile memory that records the PGN. So the previous PGN is already recorded, but now it's a new game. Okay, so let's get started. It's D4. So let's D4 and the D4. And then we want E5. So let's slide E5. When we slide, remember, it's a little tricky. So slide E5. I don't know if I did slide E4. Okay. And then I want D5. Let's go up to D5. D5 and then E4. Okay, they're invading the territories. E4, there we go. And we want to demonstrate some knockover of the board. Okay, so I want to demonstrate knockover at this moment because I remember where the pieces are, but it doesn't really matter when. So say somebody walks up to the board and go, whoops, now, gosh, this is really messed up. So people go, okay, okay, we put everything back, and basically with this board, you still have to remember where the pieces are, so perhaps you still need to keep score. But whatever it is, say we put it about all back, and then we have to tell the computer that, okay, forget about whatever, it was a knockover, so we tell the computer it's a knockover. So it's going to restart. And DGT, I don't want to knock over. Remember, I mentioned that the DGT, when it gets confused, it starts a new pigeon. So if I knock over, it's going to get a new pigeon. So we don't want to knock over DGT. We want to keep it. Okay. So so we demonstrate knock over, and then we want, what is it? F4. Now where's F4? Okay. We're going to demonstrate impassant. So we did F4, and DGT is F4 right here. There we go. Okay. And then we are going to demonstrate different ways of capturing. So we're going to impassant capture the F3 pawn. There's many ways to impassant capture. We can move him, take him, move him, take both, move him. All are supported. Maybe there's even more that I have not think about, but that's easy to add. This board can learn the different move sequences. Well, not the board, but the program, because the microcontroller is very weak. But the program can learn this. The microcontroller does remember all the sequences for debugging purposes. So if it encounters something it doesn't understand, records it in non-volatile memory, and then I go to the program and it figures it out. So let's do this capture. So as you can see, it's EXF3EP. I like that notation. Okay, so let's, what did I do? I did this DGT, we do the same. Okay, good, we captured this stuff. Okay, now, next step is Qd4, Q, queen coming out to D4. Now, DGT, queen come out to D4. And then we have C5. What is C5? Where's C? Ah, there's C. C come all the way to C5. There we go. And, DGT, C5. Okay, and then what? DXC6EP. Okay, remove both and then place. Okay, so we want to take this guy and capture him, and then we put him right here, okay? And same thing here. Remove this, and put it right here. Okay, good. Perfect. Okay, everything looks good. As you can see, my GUI is not as pretty as DGT, but I do have the FEN notation. I just didn't write it down out here. Maybe I should. Anyway, what step am I? I'm at 5. Okay, and then NE7. Where's NE7? It's Black's turn, right? Yes, so NE7. Can we go in? Okay, this knight goes to E7. Okay, I see that knight. Okay, NE7. And DGT also needs to do NE7. There we go. And then, oh gosh, what is it? QXG7. Okay, what is move adjacent, remove. QXG7. What is QXG7? QXG7. Oh, this one. Okay, so blank, move adjacent, remove. There we go. QXG7. And we are doing a lot of capturing. And the QXG7, move next, remove. That's a very natural movement. Like I said, doing debug initially, it's funny, I only support a few things I imagined, and many of the movements not supported. It's funny how we come a long way in a way. Okay, BXG7, capture, move. So what does it mean? BXG7, where's BXG7? Oh, wow, it's capturing the queen. So capture and then move. So we remove the guy we want to capture, or the girl we want to capture, and move the bishop here. So the same with DGT, move him out, move him here. Okay, here we go. Okay, what step am I on? Okay, remember. Okay, now we want to demonstrate promotion. So CXB7, CXB7, where's C? Okay, there, CXB7. I mean, we can do all kinds of captures. I like to use this kind of capture. That's natural. So we do the same thing with DGT. There we go. It's the same. And then what step am I? 7, that was 7. And then we want FXG2. Oh, this capture FXG2. Okay, there we go. And it's the same way. There we go. And then we want, what is it? BXC8 equals queen. Okay, BXC8, which one? This one. BXC8. Okay, dunk, dunk. Now he becomes queen, and we of course change him to a queen piece. There we go, now he is queen. And the same thing with DGT. Oh, very fortunate that DGT gave us a spare queen. So, oh anyway, the queen already captured, but anyway. So DGT was nice enough to give spare queens with its set. But then soon you'll realize something's not right. Okay, now FXH1, is it F? I cannot be FX, you know what? I made a typo, it's GXH1, so I'm gonna change that right now. GXH1, and this is promoting to a knight. So fortunately, I have a knight. Remember, this is just regular tournament pieces. Did I capture the knight? No, see, there's two knights, so I have a third knight from a second set. So we changed this to a knight. Now, I don't know how to do this with DGT. You know, I've never done it before because we don't promote to a knight. There's no knight. There's no extra knight. Okay, so he sees the knight. We'll just think of him as a knight. I think the DGT is very confused. Why is the DGT confused? Did I miss something in the DGT? No. And like I said, the DGT software is the weak spot on DGT boards. Anyway, so I think the DGT is done for. Next one is QXB8. QXB8, where's B8? Oh, this guy, okay, boink, chomp. Now, my board doesn't really know you've promoted this to a queen and this to a knight. However, based on later movement and logic, whether, you know, a queen can check, a knight can checkmate, queen obviously can move like sideways and up and down, diagonal, knight cannot. So based on these things, we can guess. If the guess is successful, then there's no need for user intervention. But if the guess is unsuccessful, in other words, we have doubt, then what happens is my board, when it download PGN, it'll insert a comment saying, hey, you know, I'm not sure this piece is promoted to a queen or a rook. So please specify, and then it'll generate a correct PGN. So anyway, so 2x. So now we're going to do knight to g3. Knight to g3. Oh, wait, we can't see this. Let me go over here. Okay, you see here, it's promoted the knight to a queen because that's the default. But as soon as we move to knight to, is it knight to g3? Knight to g3. Yeah, as soon as we do this, this should change to a knight because obviously queens cannot move in an L. So here we go. Knight to g3, okay? Now let's take a look. Still queen. Why is it still queen? I don't know. Maybe there's a bug. I haven't run this demo before. This demo, by the way, is this is the first time I've run it. Sometimes there's a bug. Okay, so but at least my board lasted a little longer than the DGT board. Okay, so NC3. Okay, now we're going to demonstrate castling. Let's see. What is the thing I want to do? NC3. NC3. Oh, this one. Okay, NC3. Okay. Let's see how we do it here. NC3, okay, we got that, and then we went castle. Okay, castling, no, the ideal way is a king first and then rook. So we should see OO. There we go, OO. Okay, but a lot of people, especially remember this board is made for young scholastic tournament people. So a lot of times they say, oh, I want a castle, and then they move the rook, king, and then king, or even both simultaneously, so we support that. Okay, so now I'm going to demonstrate something. Bishop to e3. Okay, let's move him to e3. I think this is e3, right? Yeah, I think it is. Okay, e3. Good. Okay, and then rxb8. Rxb8. Why do I want? Oh yes, yes. Let's get rid of this queen. Yeah, that's great. Okay, we took the queen. Okay, and then we're going to castle. Now we're going to castle rook first this time. So let's see. Rook comes here and king comes here. So does it say oh? Let me see. If it's, so, like I said, oh, it does say oh. Good. And then what do we want to do? We want to do an illegal move. And then so let's see. Well, we want to now we did oh, and then what? And then NX, oh, you know what? There's some typo here. So OOO is a white move, and then black wants to move the knight to E2 to check. So it's NX E2 check. Here we go. Now NX E2 check. Okay. NX E2. NX E2 check. See what it says. Why is it GXE2? GXE2. I don't know. Maybe there's some bugs. Like I said, this is the first time I'm running this demo. The board has been tested a little bit. Recently, I added these new capabilities like castling with the rook and stuff. But I probably should output FEN so that I know it's FEN. Come on, it's N. Oops. That's okay, I should understand. GXE2, why is it GXE2? It's probably thinks it's still a pawn or something. So now I can't demonstrate the take back of moves, but it's supported, kind of. Because who knows? Maybe we didn't test it long enough. But anyway, so there you have it.